Not everyone knows that there is a right way and a wrong way to close objects in Microsoft Access. We'll show you where hidden errors could be creeping into your database and demonstrate a quick and easy way to keep the problem at bay using an Autokeys closing macro. When a user of an Access database closes an object such as a form, any active filters or sorts on the data are automatically saved into the properties of the form. When you come back to view the form again, those filters will still be there and can lead to unexpected behaviour. For example, if the filter you were using references another form, if the system tried to apply that filter while the other form isn't open, it will cause an unexpected error to interrupt the user. There is a solution to this problem that allows you to close windows without the default behaviour of sort and filter properties being saved, and it uses Access's macro system. We can add an AutoKeys macro to our Access system that is programmed to close the object currently being viewed in a safe way. First, we need to choose a key to do this. Note that any function the key already has will be overwritten by the upcoming macro, so pick one that doesn't do anything you're interested in. We use F10, since pressing Alt has the same function. To begin, head to the Create tab of the ribbon and look to the far right. Clicking on the macro icon will start the new macro. By default, it will be called Macro 1, but we need to rename it AutoKeys when we save it later to tell the system that this macro contains new instructions on what functions our hotkey should perform. Any other custom hotkeys you make should also be defined within this macro. You'll see the macro is asking you to add a new action. From the drop-down list it provides, select Sub-Macro. Our macro will contain a sub-macro for each key we want to give a function. The sub-macro will be called Sub1. Rename it to the name of the key you want to use to close the objects, but enclosed in curly brackets. Below the name, we can add an action to this sub-macro, and thus define what should happen when this key is pressed. From the list of actions, pick Close Window. You'll see new options appear: Object Type, Object Name, and Save. If we wanted our macro to only close a specific type of Access object, like only tables, we could say so in this first box. Similarly, the second box would let us close objects with given names. The Save box is where the route to the solution of our problem is going to lie. You simply want to choose No to saving. Now save this whole macro, making sure to call it AutoKeys, and your chosen key will already start closing objects. Thus, the problem has been solved. But now, a word of warning. If you still have more to develop in your database, you'll want to avoid using this key, because if you're changing things in design view and building new features, when you press this key, it's not saving anything you're doing, so you might accidentally lose intended changes by using this key overzealously. So now you know how to avoid this specific problem and how to set up custom hotkeys, a skill you can use to make commonly performed actions just a keystroke away at any time. We hope you found this information useful. If you're interested in more Microsoft Office and VBA tips, subscribe to this channel and visit our website at software-matters.co.uk. Thanks for watching.